So, Endtroducing, easily one of my favorite hip-hop albums ever. And by the way, a quick side note, my favorite go-to album whenever I have to encounter that whole rap isn't music argument, because generally, show these people this album and all the elements that it shows of hip-hop and try to get a decent answer as to why rap isn't music. Like, this album alone completely destroys that argument. But that aside, I genuinely love when two genres that genuinely aren't supposed to really go together, or at least we don't picture them to go together too well, can cohesively conform into something so great. Like Endtroducing. And this is one of those albums that really makes me enjoy that phrase in music, there's elements of. Because in here, why I wouldn't describe this album as straight up ambient, I think it would be really weird for someone just first describe Endtroducing as an ambient album. I think there are clear elements of ambient in this hip hop album. And I don't think that the acclaim and the attention that Endtroducing has been able to garnish over the years would be there if it wasn't for the elements of ambient all over this thing. The track that perfectly shows this is Mutual Slump for me. And it's perfect because it sort of separates into different sections all of the elements that I'm talking about. Pretty much everything is shown in the beginning portion. You have very hard drum work, these very weird guitar chords, and all of this is over a Bjork sample, and it's kind of crazy that this sort of added to the ambience of the song, and all of this is being created of a sample from a pop song. But around the 44 second mark, the ambience of the song is removed, and you're focused only on the drums and sort of the hip hop part of the track. Sort of a looped out instrumental that is very catchy and sort of catches your ears really quickly. But around the minute 05 mark, the opposite happens. Hip hop, the drums, the bass lines are taken out, and you're stuck with this whole synthesizer work that sort of completely eliminates the loop and shows off one of the most important parts of ambience, and it's the complete vanishment of any regular song structure. With hip hop production, it's very easy to have a certified song structure because the drums and the snares really allow you to form a loop that you can just constantly repeat. With ambient music, you're trying to stray as far away from that as possible. You're trying to create something that isn't familiar to the listener, and just stretches out song structure to as wide a phenomenon as you can stretch it. Also, an important part about this track is the whole human element that I think is such a crucial part of ambience. When Brian Eno, who was pretty much the creator of ambient, or at least a term of it, when he came about creating ambient music, it came about with him sitting in a room and sort of hearing water droplets outside of his door and a little bit of sort of minimal music that was playing in the background. And he sort of found this way of conjoining these two things. And that's where he created ambient music.
But then I started listening to the rain and listening to these odd notes of the harp that were just loud enough to be heard above the rain. And this was a great musical experience for me. And I suddenly thought of this idea of making music that didn't impose itself on your space in the same way, but created a sort of landscape that you could belong to, you could be part of. And this, I called this, I pompously gave it a new name, which I called ambient music.
And I think the voices here in this track, when that female voice is coming in with this whole synthesizer leading instrumental, it sort of brings that human element to it. It really puts me in this picture of just driving at night with someone else as the passenger, and almost feels like this female is the passenger with me, and they're sort of just taking in the atmosphere. And I feel like adding that human element really shows off the ambience that this track has. Organ Donor is another very interesting track. This is another great showcasing of DJ Shadow just completely abandoning regular song structure, especially regular hip-hop song structure. He's more focused on creating an atmosphere, expanding the instrumental, stretching it as far as he can, and not creating anything that is repetitive, but sort of creating an atmosphere that can't really be deemed familiar to the listener. This track really reminded me of Tim Hecker's Chimerius, and just because of how much the synthesizer really takes the main driving point of the instrumental. Even though the Tim Hecker track is more synthesizer-led, and the DJ Shadow track is more organ sample-led, and it's crazy to think about that, a hip-hop instrumental can be led through an organ sample. But I think it's the utilization of this organ that really allows it to not conform to regular hip-hop song structure. But But what's really interesting about this track is that up to this point, I've really been talking about how drums are a really good way to create a loop, which is not really something that you're trying to create with ambience. But there are a lot of drums in this track. But even with the drum work, I still consider this to be a very ambient filled track just because of how sporadic the drums are. And even though they are drums, they don't really seem to be in any sort of pattern. They create all of these different types of directions with the drum work to the point where the structure of the song doesn't really seem structured at all. And just because you have drums in your song doesn't mean that it can't be ambient. Look at Vernal Equinox by John Hassell. That's an album that very much uses a lot of drum work and different types of drums, but it's very much ambient in its essence. We can look at the track Long Stem. It's important to make clear that just because a track has a sort of repetitive element doesn't necessarily mean that it can't be considered ambient. There's plenty of ambient music that does have some form of repetitive elements. We can look at Selected Ambient Works Volume 2, which I believe has a very strong repetitive element, but just how much he's able to build on those tracks really gives it that ambient feel. I think the same can be attributed to this track. And with this track, you see the guitar chords become the foreground of the track. I think we can draw similarities to the track Times When I Know You'll Be Sad by Biosphere, where he uses these guitar chords and slowly builds on top of these strings. Usually throughout hip-hop production, if you're gonna use guitar chords or if you were going to use pianos, they always kind of seem to dive back into the background. And what you see in the snares and the drums really takes the foreground, and it creates a lot of the texture of the track, and it brings that really bop your head type of feel into a lot of hip-hop songs. I think the perfect example of how usually the pianos and guitar chords when it comes to hip-hop production are laid in the background of the track is The Message by Nas. When the instrumental first comes in, you hear the guitar chords and they are the forefront of the track because they want to be emphasized. But as soon as a beat drops and the snares and the drums come in and the vocals come in, the guitar chords immediately take a step back. Fake dove, no love, you get the slug, CB4 gusto. But when you take away the vocals and you take away the drums, you can really emphasize the guitar chords to be the forefront of the track, which allows for structure to just be stretched like we see here. These guitar chords that you see being repeated isn't necessarily something that you're always going to see take the main attraction of an instrumental whenever listening to a hip-hop song. But on top of these guitar chords, pretty much everything else you're getting completely strays away from any type of repetition throughout the instrumental. Everything from the changing drums, the added violin strings towards the end of the track, the ongoing changing flutes, all equates to this feeling of an atmosphere. Not just listening to a song and trying to pick out which parts of it you get, but just taking it in as a sort of feeling and a mood instead of a song. And that's how I feel about ambient. To be honest, whenever I listen to an ambient album, I don't always feel the need to look up every track and see exactly when it starts and when it goes to the next one. A very good ambient album will just roll through each track very smoothly to the point where you can't even tell when the next one starts and the other one begins. And I get so much of that when I listen to Endtroducing. It is just such an experience from track one to the end that I just play it and let it go and see where I go mentally and see what atmosphere DJ Shadow wants to take me in, because he takes me in a different direction every single time. Now, I said before how it is important to sort of bring in those human and real world elements into the music whenever creating ambient. It sort of adds to the entire atmosphere that you create. And I believe an album like Pop really envisions a lot of that. There's a lot of these sort of nature-ish sounds that are attributed to the track that bring that real world scenario into the song. And I think Transmissions 1-3 really hone in on that. You get a combination of these old eerie recordings that look like older news reports that really bring an eerie vibe to what you're listening to. You also get a rendition of the second track, Midnight in a Perfect World, but this version seems even slower and more stretched out and more ambient-like because some of the hip-hop elements seem to be taken off. It really is such a mood setter. I would even say it's a little bit spacier than the original track, even though of course I prefer the original track, but just how smooth and out of this world and slow this sounds really give it such an ambient persona. So a lot of what I mentioned clearly shows the ambience that is introduced here in this album. So much of what we feel, the mood we get, the atmospheres are created, it strays away from a typical feeling that we get from a hip-hop album, and it delves into this entire sphere of how far can we stray stretch not only song structure, but the mood that we're giving the listener. So much with ambience is about the mood. That's why I almost feel like critiquing ambient or reviewing ambient music is almost sort of counterproductive, because ambient music was never supposed to be overly critiqued. It was just supposed to be something that you take in and you enjoy, and it gives you a certain mood. But besides all that, we cannot ignore the hip-hop elements in here. Pretty much every other track, and even every track I mentioned here, has some form of hip-hop infused in it. But even then, if it weren't for the ambience that this album brings, if it wasn't for the moods that are given here, if it wasn't for the complete abandoning of song structure, if it wasn't for the conforming of the background of the music taking the foreground and vice versa, I don't think this album would have reached the peaks that it did. And I still haven't heard an album that can really recreate and conjoin these two worlds of ambient and hip-hop so cohesively. But that's all I gotta say. Thank you for making it to the end of the video. Please let me know what you feel. I would love to have a conversation about this. Please like, please subscribe, please ring the bell so you know when I make my next video, and I'll be back very soon. Peace.